Breaking inputs on the Pune car crash case. In the Porsche crash case, the Pune police has now seized the vehicle that was used for the abduction of the driver, and a cancellation of registration of Porsche car is likely to happen today is what we are learning. And yesterday a team of experts also came for the inspection of the Porsche car at Yerwada police station. The Pune RTO has started the process of cancellation of temporary registration of the Porsche. Now, Pune RTO had in fact earlier sent a notice to the father asking for his response in 2 days, but there was no response from the father, and temporary registration was in fact from March 18th up till 27th of March, and despite that the vehicle was running on the road. These are the details that we've been supplied with as far as the Porsche is concerned. Let's quickly go across to Yesha. Yesha, share the details with us, and what could this mean for the father of the accused, considering the car had in fact been running way beyond its registration time?
In fact, when we speak of this, of course the Porsche car which was involved in the accident has been under the scanner. In fact, details from cops had also revealed that the registration fee of 1758 rupees was not paid by the family. Apart from that, there was around an amount more than 40,000 that was paid for the registration of for a section number for the vehicle. Now, because the registration, because there was no registration of the vehicle that was done, the car's registration had, temporary registration had expired on March 27. The car was in fact bought in from a Bengaluru-based dealer, and the registration was necessary. But after the accident, all these discrepancies, all these lapses have come to fore. In fact, as a part of the lapses, what the RTO had done was they had sent a notice to the accused's father in this case. However, there was no response from them, which is why now the RTO has started process of cancelling of the registration of this Porsche car. Now, this message that has been conveyed to Pune RTO would be sent to the dealer in Bengaluru, and after which the vehicle will not be able to get a fresh registration and ply on road for 12 months. Now, this is a part of the procedure of the RTO, because this car was running on the road even after there was no registration of it, which is why the registration will be cancelled and they cannot have a further registration for next 12 months. This is, amidst all of this, we've also seen that after the accident, the minor accuses license, because he does not have a license, it was also issued that he cannot get a license until he turns 25. So all of these processes are parallelly being done by the RTO, while we see there are other agencies as well which are investigating the case. In fact, a team from RTO along with the technical team from Porsche was at Yerwada police station yesterday. They had collected samples, they had collected evidences so as to understand what was the reason for the accident. They had collected further technical evidences to understand at what speed the car was being driven that night.
Right.
All of this is being pieced together for a watertight case.
Absolutely. Yes. In fact, we will keep coming back to you, Yesha, for more details. But important to also play out all those reactions that have come in. Remember, this has also now become a very volatile story as far as the political ramifications of this is concerned. A host of discrepancies have also surfaced. Let's also play out how various politicians have reacted.
ये इसमें किसी का भी दबाव नहीं है. मैं बार बार आपको बोल रहा हूँ कि सीएम ने भी बताया, डिप्टी सीएम देवेंद्र जी ने भी बताया, पुलिस मुख्यालय में प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस लेके बताया, मैंने पुणे में बताया, अभी मैं मुंबई में प्रेस में बोल रहा हूँ, बिल्कुल राजकीय दबाव नहीं है.
जो डॉक्टर हैं जिन्होंने सील करके ये रिपोर्ट फोरेंसिक को भेजी थी, उनको कल हमने डिटेन किया था. उनके प्राथमिक तपास में ये बात सामने आई कि उन्होंने जुवेनाइल एक्यूज्ड का सैंपल लिया था, लेकिन उसने उसको डस्टबिन में फेंका था और उसने एक किसी और व्यक्ति का सैंपल से उसको रिप्लेस करके उस पर उस जुवेनाइल एक्यूज्ड का नाम लिख करके उसको फोरेंसिक लैब को भेजा था. ये चीज उसने डॉक्टर अजय तावरे के ससून हॉस्पिटल के HOD फोरेंसिक मेडिसिन के हैं, उनके कहने पे और उनके द्वारा और ये सब मिलके क्रिमिनल कॉन्स्पिरेसी करके ये एक्ट, ये कंडक्ट उनकी हुई थी.
आई एंड माय कलीग विपुल दुशिंग वी बोथ सबमिटेड दैट द सेक्शंस व्हिच आर लेवल्ड आर नॉट गेटिंग अट्रैक्टेड. दैट वाज आवर फर्स्ट सबमिशन. वी आर नो वेयर रिलेटेड टू अक्यूज, वी आर डॉक्टर्स. सो अनदर लिंब ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट वॉज दैट Secondly, we argued on the point of police custody that custodial interrogation is not required because the reasons attributed was that they want to see certain registers, telephones, CCTV footages. For that, custodial interrogation is not required. That was argument.
So what was the financial transaction?
No, that was not related to us. We were only related to a sampling.
Today they brought before the court on the basis of police want to police custody on the ground of they want to on whose direction they were handling these blood samples. And for that purpose, police claiming the police custody. But however, those sections were not applicable, this accused person, those are all the bailable section, and in bailable section PCR should not be granted. This is our argument. Under section 201, 213 and 214 of IPC labeled by the investigation officer. It is alleged, but they were not specific who on whose supplier or how much quantum were given to this. They were just vaguely alleged that they were suspected that there is a monetary transaction for this transaction. We have gone through the court basically on the basis considering the police custody ground initially for the sake of we can say the media trial.
उसके लिए हम हमारी इंक्वायरी बटाएंगे, पुलिस से उनकी जो मालूम है उनकी उनकी लेंगे और उनको तत्काल निलंबित या बर्तरफ किया जाएगा। नहीं, मुझे क्या अभी पता नहीं है, मैं मालूम करने के बाद बोलूंगा।